Yes, another video and more retro goodness from Atlantis Toy and Hobby. They sent over their Convair Space Shuttlecraft. This is a fantasy spacecraft developed a very long time ago, and because Atlantis bought all the older unused Revell molds, they can now release cool kits like this for us to build and have these fantasy space kits that kids in the late 50s and 60s were having a blast building and dreaming about satellites and spacecraft and aliens and to go with all the cool movies that were coming out that time in black and white. Check out the cool box art of a built model. Now this is completely fantasy, so you can build and color your model any way you want, all right? And well, you can always do that, but especially with ones like this that are completely fantasy and sci-fi, decorate and build them how you wish. Now we see we got a whole bunch of figures here. We got four astronauts and we got three crew members on the ground, and they're all attached by their skulls, which probably hurts a lot. We've got different parts of the shuttle and the landing areas. They've got multiple stages for this rocket. We've got the glider stage, the propulsion stage, the ground stage. We've got the launch pad. Check out the molding on that. We got the launch pad down there. We got part of the glider. Now, how future, what would you call it? Prediction? Future alluding to? Check out the engines on there. All the nozzles and the details on those engines, all the ribbing, that someone that designed this actually kind of had the idea of the space shuttle right with a first try. A glider that returns to Earth, check it out. A separate stage from the rocket, a glider that returns to Earth, and they call it a glider numerous times in the manual and the instructions. We can take a look here. Nice, really nice smooth molding. You wouldn't even have to paint the white parts if you didn't want to. Just minimal flash. I call it like hair flash or sunburn skin flash. It comes off really easy with the swipe of a knife. We got parts of our glider here and the main rocket. Check that out. I mean, the design overall was not that far. We got the stage of the rocket that sits underneath the glider, the second stage to get it all the way up into space. And supposedly, when you're all done, you can take this apart and expose the different stages. I don't know if I'll set mine up that way, but you can do that. We've got the cockpit here with little instrument clusters. When we get some paint on it, you'll see it better. But they even have little gauges in there. We got the top of the cockpit area. We've got more glider parts here with fins and some of that, I'll call it sunburn skin flash again, skinny stuff. We got different parts of the rockets. We got parts of our launch tower here, our structure, which is nice that they're together. I can paint them all as one and then detach them and attach them to the base. And that's it for the styrene plastic in the kit. It's not a whole lot of parts in there. You get a very large decal sheet. Decorate this up. NASA, Air Force. Too bad, you know, as a joke, too bad they don't have Space Force decals in here, because that would be hilarious. I would build it up as Space Force right away. Just as a little comical build, but you can do Air Force emblems, beautiful NASA emblems. I love those. All those different kinds of decorations on there, flags, anything you would need for the kit. And in these kits, a flexi file. Yeah, they're working with flexi file. Now, we've seen other kits with these in them. As a surprise, this one's got the flexi file in it. Mine in the box was a medium. So make sure you order yours. Now, I'm going to get these parts assembled, and we're going to come back for a sub-assembly. These vintage kits are the type of kits where you're going to pass them up on the shelf or see them online and think, meh. If you actually pick these up like you should, you're going to find out that they're a lot of fun and they're well engineered for the day. They really work well. Check this out. None of those stages are glued together. The actual stages themselves have their assembly completed, but none of those are glued. It's holding itself together right there. This is our launch ring, and I'll be painting that separately. We've got the launch base here. I've cut most of the tree free from both trees of sections. We got our eight triangles and we got our two rectangles. These will be painted up a nice bright launch pad color. We've got our interior here. This is the cockpit and its cover. We'll be able to paint this up. We'll have to do mostly hand painting and then attach our figures inside so it looks like they're flying the ship. And then this is, of course, the protective top over that that should push on. This is the top of the final glider stage. It won't hold on when it's like this because I've got part of the tree still attached, so I can get a nice coat of paint, then clip that off, and then I just use a little brush to touch that little tiny minuscule section up, but that fits in there nice and even. We can look at that before we're done here. We got the base, that's all ready to go. We just have to stick that to our painting area, get that all painted up in our preferred color. We've got our figures, very easy to paint them up like so. Take a knife, swipe off any excess flash. They're at such a small scale, we're not gonna have to do faces or anything. It will just be very basic figure painting by hand. If you wanna use bases for the three workmen, work people on the base of the launch pad, these are the bases you can use. I'm not using those, so I'm just gonna toss them on the side. We've got our complete rocket here, which is cool. You can see the size of it with my hand. It's a nice size. We can start taking it apart stage by stage. We've got the top of the rocket. I'll take that off, set that down. We've got our main rocket with all the fuel and the five big engines to launch it into space. That is all set up like so. And you can see, just using glue and a little bit of the X-Acto knife, we really don't have any seams that I'm going to worry about. I don't worry about it much to begin with, but that is all set to go. That is a nice piece on its own. Whoop, we got three pieces here that all hold together when they're attached. You can see how they interlock to that lower rocket there. We've got the three pieces of our glider here, and they assemble. We've got more fuel cells to shoot it into space. We got the bottom part. So this would detach, and this would continue on. Let me push it all back together for you. So hard to do on camera. Push it all back together, that's what it looks like. So that's a cool rocket itself. If you wanted to glue this base on there and leave it like that, that would also look cool too, since it's your vehicle. Now I'll show you, while we got it on here, how that will just sit on top. Once that arm's not there, that will sit on top and cover it up. So we've got our sections like this. Then the main section will separate. This will fall back to Earth or wherever. And then we've got the glider section here with its own stage to finish getting it all the way into space. And that will detach. You can see that section's got its own wings, got its own ailerons and everything. So if you wanted to, you could use a panel line scriber to open those up more. It's got its own engines and everything. That glues on. And then we have our glider. And this is what would return to Earth with the crew in it. I marked those little black dots. I'll show you later. You want to make sure that when you glue the bottom of your glider on, the little black raised areas are facing up. I made them black so they're easier to see, so that when you put your cockpit in here, it will glue into place solidly and have it in there. But we want to get all this painted separately. The glider looks awesome. It's got its detail on there, and it's got its little winglets and everything. So all the parts go together super easy. It's a lot of fun to put together. There's no problems with fit. Clean up the little bit of flash with a swipe and an X-Acto knife. That's all you have to do. The fits are still great given the age of this kit and its origin. The fits are excellent. There's not a problem. Anyone of any skill level so far could get this together. I'm going to start throwing things in paint. Let's go over there. with stuff out of paint, the build really speeds up quick. I mean, there's only a couple things that I have to get paint on. I want to do the rockets in the back of each section that has rockets. So I will be hand painting those. We'll take a look at that. But everything is done in its colors. You know, we've got our white, we've got our concrete base here. We've got our orange launch ring and launch tower assembly painted with that Rust-Oleum orange. Anything that I cut off these trees and expose as white, what I do is I just spray a little bit of the color into a cup and use a small brush to touch up those areas. It's not a big deal. Check out the chrome. That's that spray chrome. Of course, it's not perfect chrome, and I don't care. I just got to paint that up. And that actually requires no paint. Sorry, I misspoke. We'll get the lid on that, the cover of the cockpit, and that's how that's going to look. You know, that paint would also be cool if anyone, hint, hint, to any model maker watching this, make the two versions of the Flight of the Navigator, the walnut shell-looking one and the long, super streaky jet-looking one, and paint them up with that Rust-Oleum Bright Coat Chrome, and you're all done. So that's just a little side note, but everything goes together well. It's going to be cool. I always build these Atlantis kits with the perspective of a kid. You bought this way back in the day. You're going to assemble it. You're going to have fun, but you're not going to go insane with it and go with details. I will be painting all of the eight figures, the ground crew, and the astronauts, so that we can have a little bit of scale and detail on that base. And inside, I will be doing very minor touch-up hand painting on the inside with the paint on there. You can see those control panels have very fine little dots on them. I'll probably paint the tops of each one black and then just touch each one with a little bit of colored craft paint to get that in. We'll take a look at that in a little bit. So I'm going to get to going. The figures are all painted black now, so I can do their base coats. They're not going to be extremely detailed. I mean, look at my finger and look at the size of those figures. We don't have to go crazy in detailing everything, but we'll get enough paint on them so that they look good. We'll get that base assembled. We'll get the engines painted and return. Thank you. a fun, fast rocket to build up and detail. Let's take a look at what we got done so far and what we used for it. The cockpit is all glued in. It's got its little details on it. It looks awesome. It's got its five astronauts all decorated as well and put in place. They are microscopic, so you're not going to see a huge amount of them, especially once we put the capsule top, the glider top on it. You can see the very fine lines I created, top and bottom, for the ailerons that are molded in on the parts here. You can just barely make them out, which is how they should be. Using a Molotow black liner, you can pick your size. I picked this 0.05 size. These are available from modelroundup.com. They have them. They make really nice work of that, and if you make a mistake, these take a little bit longer to dry, so you can wipe it off and fix your problems. We got the base assembled. That looks awesome sauce. Bright orange for the launch pad. Or for the launch pad, we got concrete. We got bright orange for the rocket support. That is awesome, and it all just pushes in all the way through, and then just use a little super glue if any parts are loose, and to hold the trim rings on. We got the upper part of the cabin. I painted it a brighter white, so it was, like, you know, more reflective for light inside and all that. I did find out that once this was glued in, even though it's in the proper place, I did have an issue with fitment of the top going all the way in. I fixed that by cutting off the little nib that was on the front, and now it just pushes in tight, and it friction fits, so you don't even need that nib to hold it in. The figures are painted that will be standing on the launch pad. We got them all set up with their Army Painter colors that we looked at. Then I took them over and shot them with Rust-Oleum Clear Flat. And then all I will do after this is use some Army Painter Soft Tone to give them a little bit of wash and extend the details, but you really wouldn't even need to. They are finely detailed as they are. When I cut them free, I'll just use a little bit of the yellow that I used back here to retouch up their helmets, and then super glue them in place. We all know that the super glue I use all the time is dollar store super glue. Works absolutely fine and comes in tiny quantities. So if you know, drop it, forget it, the top dries, you're fine. I did paint all the engines on all of the stages. To do that, I just used a quick paintbrush of Tester's Metallic Graphite. Used Ceram Coat White for any white details I needed, like the astronauts and the inside of the cockpit. And I used Model Master Olive Drab for the uniforms on the ground crew. All I need to do now is apply the decals that you want to use. You can use Air Force, you can use NASA, you can combine them if you wish. And then set it all on the base and we're done. Glue the little guys in on the bottom to give us some scale perspective. I'm going to attach those decals right now and then we'll be back for the final. An awesome reissue from the folks at Atlantis, the Convair Space Shuttlecraft. You get to build this any way you want because it's a complete fantasy build and it's all kind of fun. Now, I like my theme with it. When I saw it on the website and had to have it, I wanted to go with the metallic dropaway sections, 2 and 3, the white main rocket, the orange base, and the gray launch pad, and then chrome out that shuttle. That glider, that just looks so cool. And I did mine up in mostly NASA decals. That's the way I like it. That's the way I did it. Highlighted the ailerons on the glider and the second stage there so that you can actually, you know, has a little bit of detail to it. Doesn't just look like a finned rocket. And this thing is ready to explore space in the unknown. It's so cool that these retro kits are coming back. Now, Atlantis sent this directly from their website. I will link so you can go pick up your own Convair Space Shuttlecraft. Don't forget that cool little flexifile sanding stick in the package. We got the three figures. We got the astronauts we saw inside the cockpit, all five of those, and detailed. So all kinds of fun. You could build this up. I know a lot of us right now, when this is being filmed, there's a lot of spare time for reasons out there that we're all being staying at home. This is the kind of thing where if you're in a kit slump and you don't want to dive into anything really, really difficult, really extended, here's something you can bang out in a day or two and not have any problems at all. Over a weekend or when the kids aren't driving you nuts being home from school, you can have a lot of fun and put this together and enjoy yourself. I will take some pictures of all the stages apart at the end of the review. We'll pop the cockpit open for a couple stills as well, and we will see you at the next review. Always make sure, have fun, build for you. Build your models the way you want to see them. Thanks for your support.